Well, it was multifaceted. It was a personality where we believed very strongly about the importance of public policy issues. Secondly, we believed fervently that as a sort of a custodial of a large corporation and as custodians of vast resources and employment and everything else, that we were not doing our job if we did not participate in the marketplace of ideas in the debates on public policy issues. That if we didn't participate, we deserved what we got because the debate would be skewed against us because our views were not included. So that was a very strong part of our personality. Third part of our personality was we believed in that a democracy is composed of a group of free institutions. We believed in free markets, freedom of speech, freedom of the press, academic freedom, freedom to organize and participate in union activities, and that part of the responsibility of the institutions that had more economic resources than others was to foster the safety and growth and protection of those free institutions. Because if any of the free institutions fall, they all fall. And so we felt that we had certain resources that could strengthen what made up the United States for what it was, which is an accumulation of free institutions. Beyond that, we believe that artistic freedom and ability to support artistic endeavors was a private sector responsibility. The government should not be involved in support of the arts, that the private institutions and the public should be supporting them. And we put our money where our mouth was on that.